disappointed to see the end of combo number five, but we'll get back to the action instead. He enjoyed doing it so much, he did it virtually straight away. It's two apiece, and we've got some of these today. Felt like there was really nothing going on for a while, and all of a sudden points just started ticking over nicely.
Leg control really well, score points to the side, and to the back Braganca showing there that although he just uses leg control a lot, he does have plenty of other weapons. Scoring the spinning kick there, should be 4-2.
Ruben
thinks there's an extra point coming. There it is. Almost maneuvering Braganca around the man himself, wasn't he? As if he was his own chess piece.
Eventually,
he made the strike that counted. He's got a knee into the side there. Again, Falat trying to be the aggressive here as they go into the final 30 seconds.
And surprise him with the back leg to score a point.
European champions with another battle here. A bit loose with technique, perhaps every now and then. Falat leaves himself a little bit open when he goes on the attack. That might be where Braganca can really capitalise in this one.
Yeah, definitely. As you saw with the spin kick that Braganca scored earlier. When they did clash together, but you know, like Braganca fully exposed that situation with the spinning kick on the back foot into scoring the 2 points for that. Yeah, definitely. I think especially when the situation is close to the end, you want to have a good idea of what the points are. Obviously, you want to be at a safe distance to do so. But if it scores a tie, if you think you've scored and you're ahead, you need to be able to change your tactics very quickly. So a quick glance will serve that purpose for you.
You can get caught out with that little bit of lack of
control. Yeah, definitely. It's where you've got to be well aware
of where you are.
Picking off that spin with the punch.
Yeah, that was a great effort for the point, because he's been going on the back foot whenever Falat's been using his check with the front leg. And there he just switched up, looked the claws off as Falat followed up the check.
Sloppy stuff from the Portuguese fighter. He's looking happy. He not twice, three times this round. Close range of Braganca gets him within two.
40 seconds.
This has certainly been, don't take your eyes off it, kind of accident, but now picks off another. Braganca goes back in with a short range punch, doesn't register.
This is where Fala really excels, because now he knows Braganca has to come at him. He's so good with his leg. Every time he comes in, he can check the weight of the body, he can flick it high. He just gives Braganca so much to think about. He can't just go out and full guns.
European champion needs something here in the final few seconds. What can he find? He found a brick wall in Asia. Asha Fala takes the victory over the European champion. They meant business.
Yeah, definitely. As you saw there, once he got ahead, he was in full control. Braganca had to go at him. Every time he went at him, Fala was ready with a response, whether it's to the body or high. Braganca just couldn't get an easy point. He's not one point to go, but they were doing enough.
I'll be winning the European champion against the Asian Championship gold medal winner. Asian Championship gold medal winner came out on top. That man there. We'll be back a little bit later on. We're about to move on to the next semi-final. I'm going through the highlights of that.